This life is beautiful.
What's going on there?
Maybe this man armed robber.
This man no fit be armed robber. If they rob him, kill him for here now.
Well, this man never die. He's still there alive.
Now true. Make I come out here before police come.
Okay, let's see. It's Adams.
Oh no. Is he dead?
I don't think so. He's still alive.
Stop it! Stop it! Stop it!
What's the matter with you? Oh, you want to play hard to get, right? Okay. I like the game.
Please don't do this to me. I beg you in the name of God. Don't do this to me. Please don't do this to me. I beg you in the name of God. Please. No. 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 You see that? Was it not just this morning we were discussing this man? His hand up has finally caught up with him. Let's get out of here.
Are you driving away? What happens to that man? Are you leaving him to his fate?
But what could have happened to him? I thought you said he was released this morning.
Yes, but I don't know what is going on here, baby. Please, let's get away from here. Please, let's go. Let's go.
What about all the lessons of life you heard from Sister Mary? What about the Word of God you've been studying? Remember the story of the Good Samaritan? Can't you be a good Samaritan to this man?
Eperi, what are you doing?
We have to help him.
What?
See, come, let's help him.
What's wrong with you?
Are you just going to stand there and watch? Come give me a hand. Tamuno.
Hello, Ada.
Hey, Bayo. How are you? Are you at work?
No, I'm at the house finishing it.
Bayo. Why didn't you tell me so I can come and help you make some suggestions?
Don't you know that a woman's idea goes a long way in helping furnish a house, especially the kitchen?
I'm sorry, it skipped my mind.
Bayo, that's not good enough. No, that's not good enough at all. It means you don't think of me as much as I think of you.
I said I'm sorry. It's not too late. You could come tomorrow.
Okay. Forgive him.
Okay. All right. Bye.
I'll see you tomorrow then. Yes.
Oh, you can say that again.
I'm going to steal it.
You two, you're looking so awesome.
Thank you.
Hey. What's up? You said I should come immediately.
Babe,
This is Bayo. He doesn't want to propose with his eyes open, no.
And then make him propose with his eyes closed now. But wait, which method do you want? Is it magical or spiritual style?
Babe, for now, no spiritual work. I prefer that magic one. But you need to explain to me again.
You see, the magic style is... you will sleep with him without protection and later announce to him that you are pregnant. But have you slept with him?
But yes, we have, but only once.
Hey, that's all it takes, as long as he didn't use protection.
He didn't use it. I made sure of that one.
Sweetheart, you're on course.
Yeah.
Bring some money. We are going to the pharmacy. It is called vitamin K. Even if by chance sleeping with him didn't get you pregnant, you see that vitamin K will give you pregnancy signs. Will give you pregnancy signs that will make him think you are pregnant. Like swollen legs, vomiting, and the likes. My darling, the more you look, the less you see.
Oh, baby! Let's go there! I'm coming!
Go and bring money. It is called vitamin K. Signs, pregnancy signs. Don't worry. It is me now, Rachel. Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow. Oh, that was nice. Yes.
Let me get it.
Okay.
Hello. Good to see you.
Yeah, how are you?
You're welcome.
How is everybody doing?
Ah, welcome, Uncle Chris.
Yeah, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah.
Please sit.
Yeah, thank you, yeah.
You're welcome.
Yes,
please, what can we offer you?
Nothing, thanks.
Nothing?
I won't be staying long. I just came to give you messages and I'll be on my way back to the hospital.
Oh, okay.
Ngozi, this is your tuition for a term and all you need to get to finish your nursing school.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Come on.
God will bless you.
Mr. Chris, thank you so much. I really appreciate this. God bless you.
Come on, come on. Please, you don't have to do this. You're embarrassing me. Stand up.
Thank you.
Right. And, take it. Ngozi spoke passionately on your behalf, and I have to put in a word for you in our hire company. The purchasing manager said you should come and see him. Call him first on this number and go over to see him about supply to the hire company.
Oh, you spoke on my behalf too, Ngozi. Oh, thank you. Yeah, thank you, darling. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much, Uncle Chris. I will go there and let you know.
All right, there's no problem. In that case, I'll go back to the hospital, but I'll come later in the evening to see you girls, okay?
Oh, okay. Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Right, you take care of yourself.
All right, have
Bye.
A nice day.
Bye. Bye.
And
Bye.
Thanks for dropping by. No. Thank you.
Treated like a human being. The moment I entered, the man said, tea or coffee? I said, sure. Which one is tea or coffee? Trust me now, as a sharp buttercut girl, I did not want to fold my hand. I just said, no. And then the man said, okay. And then Nina explained to me that after I'd registered, that I would start supplying them things in the region of 2 million naira. 2 million naira. And this would improve as time goes on.
That is good.
Yes!
But where do you intend to get the money to take it off?
Sweetheart, that is where the miracle lies.
He said he would introduce me to known suppliers that would give me supplies only if I deposit 50% of the money, which they will advance me. But you know, this can only be if Uncle Chris will guarantee me.
So, don't worry. Chris will guarantee for you.
Are you sure? Hey, Ngozi.
Thank you, Ngozi. Thank you.
God bless you. You're a godsend.
Don't you get tired of thanking me.
I will thank you.
Go and eat. Later on, we'll just go over and say thank you to Chris.
Once this takes off, I will never prostitute this body again. This body is a temple of God.
God, I thank you.
He has done for me. He has done for me. He has done for me.
He has done for me.
Whatever that cannot do. Whatever that cannot do.
He has done for me.
Thank you. Ngozi, please give me food.
Let me carry
your bag. Give me water.
Let's go. You want me to come and eat food
and have fun.
Hello, Tamino.
Hello, Alhaji Ahmed. Something strange is going on here.
What is it?
My sister and I went to dispose of dustbin at the site. And guess what? We saw people gathered at the spot. And when we reached it out of curiosity, we discovered they were gathered around Adams.
What happened to him?
He was lying down there bleeding on his head and unconscious. He was still alive and my sister insisted we took him to the hospital. We are there now.
What hospital is that?
The specialist clinic.
All right. I'll be there in 5 minutes. I'm actually around that area, okay? See you in 5 minutes. All right.
Okay, I'm waiting, okay. That was Alhaji Ahmed. He'll be here in a moment. I think he's around the corner.
Okay.
How is he?
He will live. He took a bomb to the head. Whoever dumped him at the refuse site probably thought he was dead. It must have been a very hard bomb. He was lucky you brought him in when you did. Otherwise, he would have suffered serious internal bleeding and he would have died by tomorrow.
Okay, thank you very much. She should be on our way.
By the way, who's picking up the bills?
Well, I'll do that.
Wait a minute. Is this not the same guy who raped you?
He is. Well, I know he might look strange, but believe me, I don't even know what I am doing. I find myself being pushed to help him. Besides, I put what he did to me behind me. And I simply see him as any other person that needs help.
Okay. All right. See you later then.
Thank you very much.
Good afternoon, Alhaji.
Good afternoon, Alhaji.
Good afternoon. Tamino, what you told me on the phone, is it true?
Yes. He's under observation, but the doctor says he will leave. Alhaji, do you know anything about this?
You mean if I am responsible for what happened to him? No, Tamino. But I wish I am the one that did it to him.
Yeah, I know how you feel. Like Buma once said to me, I am not the only one that has grudges against Adams. But come to think of it, don't you think it is this Buma that did it or knows something about it?
You know, I thought about it on my way here. It seems there's a little problem in their camp. Anyway, it's to my benefit. Anyway, like they say,
Yeah, I was invited again and stuff. Cannot stand. I want them to fall.
Let us not forget the vengeance from God. God said vengeance is His. He may be getting away with his crimes, and it might just be a little thing that puts him out.
You're right. In fact, you're very correct. I have to get back to my office right now. Tauno, thanks for the information.
Thank you very much, Alaji. Let's go.
Okay.
Who are you trying to call? I'll be in the car.
Thank you.
What is it?
They found Adams. He's still alive.
How? Who called you?
Tamuno. He said Adams is still alive. And Ahmed is suspecting that I have something to do with it. He said he's calling me because of the favor I did him.
If Adam is still alive, let's just disappear. Let's go for a visa and leave this town.
No. We can't leave town. We stay in town and do our business. And we monitor everything that is going on. Look, Millie, we need to invest that money in an area where we know very well.
So, where do we go to live?
I know the perfect place. We pack tonight. First thing tomorrow morning, we set off.
No.
I'll take care of it.
Come on. It could be food poisoning from what we ate. The earlier, the better.
Don't worry yourself. I'll be fine.
You sure?
Yes. Please, just let me catch my breath.
Sorry.
What's wrong with her?
I think it's something she ate.
How wrong you are, bro. I think you've been trapped.
What do you mean by that?
She has trapped you with pregnancy.
I won't comment about that now, because you've never liked her.
Oh, bro. It's not like that. I mean it. She's hanging pregnancy on you.
How do you know how they hang pregnancy on anyone? Or have you hanged one on someone before?
No, but...
You don't know what you're saying.
Hello, Ada. How are you feeling?
I'm not feeling good. I didn't want to tell you earlier, but I feel better now, so I'll tell you.
What's it?
I'm pregnant.
I don't get you.
I went to collect the results of the test I did earlier, and it shows I'm pregnant.
Listen, I don't understand this. Maybe we should discuss this tomorrow.
Okay. Tomorrow then. Tomorrow then. Is it not tomorrow?
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Mrs. Ema. How are you and your family?
We're fine, sir. It's good to see you here again.
Oh, good to see you too. Good to see you. By the way, I came to check why my gratuity has not been paid. And I do understand that other people have been paid. Not just that. I'm being harassed every day to quit my official residence.
Huh?
Yes.
Sir.
Yes.
I have finished work on your papers.
Okay.
And passed it to the DG. Mr. Eric.
Mm-hmm.
But he's been sitting on it.
I see.
I have inquired of him separately with a view to seeing that it gets the attention for speedy passage.
Okay.
But he warned me. One day he told me if I am not careful about the way I pursue your matter,
okay,
that I'll be joining you in the job market.
Mm-hmm. In that case, I'll be going in there to see him.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Okay, you bring it into the office. We look through it. Look at the gray areas and see what we can do. Farm up on all the necessary. Okay. All right. All right, brother. Okay, let's see at the club then. All right. In regards to the family. All right. Bye-bye. Yes.
I can't remember asking you to come into my office.
I entered because I have no intention of being kept out there for ages.
Then I can ask you to get out of my office.
I will not leave. I will not leave here until you tell me why you refused to sign my gratuity and why you have continued to harass me to vacate my official residence.
Beautiful. I'll tell you. I withheld my signature on purpose because it is payback. Do you know that your refusal to grant the governor the contract to supply ruined my chance of picking nomination to the assembly?
I did what I had to do because it was the right thing to do. I will do it all over again to satisfy my conscience. Besides, that assembly you are aspiring to is better off without people like you.
Then you will have to wait an eternity for your gratuity.
Whenever it pleases God, I will get my gratuity with or without you sitting there as the DG. I will.
Let's wait and see. Now, as for your official residence, I am giving you only 1 month to get out from there or you get your things thrown out.
So you think sitting there as the DG, you forget too soon how many DGs have sat on that seat, including me? It is turn by turn. It is not permanent for anybody. You think you are fighting me? You are wrong. You are fighting God Almighty, at whose command and guidance I did my job.
We will see.
Good day, Mr. DG.
Come in now. Come in.
And you? Why did you allow that man to come into my office without first checking with me?
What's that?
Yeah. Miss Emma, I can see that your days in this establishment are numbered. I'm counting for you. Now get out of my office.
Yes, sir.
Shoo! Get out of my office. Why does this man keep getting on my nerves?
Hello, Dr. Kemi.
Since you have refused to visit the hospital to check on the patient you brought here, I'm calling you to let you know that after a month here, he will finally be discharged.
Wait a minute, Dr. Kemi. I'm not his relative or friend. I brought him in on compassionate grounds. Besides, I've completed payment of his bills.
I know. And I also remember what he did to you. But the truth is, his case has taken a different twist. And since no one else has come to the hospital to visit him, I feel you're the closest person to him now.
What twist has his condition taken, eh? I thought you said you're discharging him.
Yes, he is well now. But he doesn't remember anything. I mean, it happens once in a while. He doesn't remember anything about himself or anyone. I'm thinking that if you can come around, I mean, it could help him remember something.
Hey, Dr. Kemi, listen. I don't think I want to get involved with that man more than I already have. Because he took all the goodwill he needed for me to bring him to the hospital.
But you're the only one that can help him.
Look, Dr. Kemi, please don't hang this on me. I can't do it. I'm sorry.
Hello, sunshine.
How's your case coming along?
I hope your witnesses are cooperating.
Challenge to your spiritual growth, my dear.
But I've done a lot for him by saving his life.
Life of loss of memory, of what uses it to him.
Why must they be me of all people? Why?
It looks so, my dear. They're calling upon you. Let us look at it this way. Why must it be you that found him almost dead and saved him? Why must it be you that fell on your laps to come and help him? Do you think it's coincidence? It is not. You are overcoming. Continue with it. As you do it, it wipes sad memories of hate and pain.
So this is how much?
But this cup should be the same with this set.
Yeah, it's the same but this one is not the same.
So can I add this, join this to this one?
Hello.
Ronke.
Adeswa. Hey, how are you?
Very well. How are you and your children?
Oh, fine, thank you. How is daddy?
He's doing very well.
And my kids, eh?
They're fine. I just came around to pick some things.
Let me just do the same.
Okay. Oh, I've been hoping to see you. It's concerns Bayo and Adao. In fact, given some circumstances that has just developed, I decided that I must find time to see you.
Adeswa, you know how much I want my son, Bayo, to settle down. But the delay has been caused mostly by the fact that he's fixing his house.
Mm-hmm.
But now that he's through, we are going to start something. So what are the circumstances that have just developed?
I noticed that Ada has taken in. And when I asked her if she has told Bayo, she said she doesn't want to embarrass him. Sure, you know our children. You know how they are. And me, I am really afraid for her. Because if her father gets to know, he would disown her outrightly.
Really? Is Ada pregnant for Bayo?
Me, I never even knew that they've been at it.
Well, there's nothing to be embarrassed about. I'll be going to see Bayo tomorrow.
Okay.
And when I get to his place, I will make sure I bring up this topic. Don't worry,
Thank you. Don't let me disturb you, okay?
So, go and get your. I will get my.
My brother. So, I want to add this. I want to join this once. Okay?
Yeah, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you, mommy. Welcome.
How is everything?
Very fine. Let me help.
Thank you.
No problem, mommy.
You're looking good.
Thank you. You're looking very nice, ma.
Thank you, my dear. What happened? Where is everybody?
Mommy, good morning, ma.
Good morning, my dear.
You're beautiful.
Thank you.
Wow.
You're looking good.
Thank you.
Are you just waking up?
This life is beautiful, but everything seems to be falling apart. The more you get, the more you feel sad, whoa, this life, wherever
it is. Hey, Tamara, do you know why I'm happy?
Why are you happy?
I have an invitation to a whitey party this night. They need two girls. Hello? Say something now.
Oh, sorry. What did you say?
I said I have an invitation for the night, and it is a whitey. They need two girls. Say, we should be there by 10 p.m. till morning.
Rita,
yes.
I am no longer interested in such lifestyle. Prostitution to me was what I did because there was nothing else for me to do to sustain myself and my mother. But thank God for Ngozi today. I have a contracting business I've been doing for months now. So why prostitute?
I knew it. See, since this Ngozi girl came into this house, everything has changed here. You don't even notice me anymore. Now you're telling me you want to do runs again.
Do you know how much I detested having to bare my body and open my legs to every Tom, Dick and Harry just because they want to give me little money to fend for myself? Thank God, because he has saved me from that shame, dehumanization and indignity. Rita, I would encourage you to find something else to do and forget that lifestyle. In fact, you can come in with me so that we can just put that lifestyle behind us.
I can't believe you're living this life.
I mean, we have fun and gifts from men and Rita.
I want you to stop mentioning anything concerning runs to me. I am no longer interested in that lifestyle. In fact, if there's a way I could scrub myself and wash up the memories inside and outside of me, I would gladly do it. Since I can't, do not remind me of it anymore.
So that is it. Ngozi has disrupted our life. Does she think she can just come in here, do whatever she likes, and then get away with it? We shall see.
This life is beautiful.